Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a surprise Trader Joe's haul because it's Friday, and just because it's a new year doesn't mean that my schedule's gonna change. I'm still doing Friday Trader Joe's hauls, which include all of the seasonal and the new items, so you don't miss out on anything every week at Trader Joe's. And of course, the taste tests that are happening tomorrow. So taste tests on Saturday, and that will showcase all of the new items that myself, my husband, and my five-year-old son will be trying to tell you guys how we like them or not. So that is kind of the overview, but I would love to welcome you into my home. I'm gonna be sharing with you all of the amazing products I got this week at Trader Joe's. There's actually quite a bit of new items, so I can't wait to share them. And then of course, I will be showing you everything that I got for myself and my family to eat for the week. And I'm doing a lot of meal planning now. I don't know if this is like new or maybe it's just for this week, but nevertheless, let's get started and check out this week's Trader Joe's haul. All right. Ooh, baby, just hold tight. We're up the moonlight. Believe in the magic. Hello and welcome to the first week into January. How are you all doing? I hope you're all feeling great. I sure am, and I'm gonna get started with the frozen stuff. Nothing's changed from 2021 to 2022 because I'm gonna do this first and then put it away. We're gonna start here with the organic green vegetable foursome. I've purchased this many times. I haven't gotten it in quite a while, but as you will see, this is kind of like a reset. The last 2 weeks of the year, Tim and I went real hard and we ended up eating basically whatever we wanted, and that's what the holidays are about. So no complaining, I just wanted to tell you, we're back on track. So I'm getting lots of frozen veggies. So we got this one. I also got the stir fry vegetables. I love having this on hand too. Having these things frozen is so convenient because if I just want to make something like off the top of my head, or if there's things that I don't want to run out for that day, it's nice to have these frozen things. So these two things are one of my favorite frozen breads that Trader Joe's sells. We have the garlic naan and then the tandoori naan. Both are great for different things. I have made pizzas on these before. A lot of people make pizzas on these because they're really great. I also love to just heat this one up and use it as a vessel for my hummus. I just made a tikka masala the other night. It was so delicious. And I heated up some of this bread and then we just had that on the side and it was amazing. I also absolutely love the garlic naan. It's very garlicky though, so my son doesn't like it. So I always buy the plain and the garlic to have both on hand. But if it were me, I would always go for the garlic one. So these are great to have. And again, frozen, super easy. You just heat them in the oven for like 2 minutes, not even like a minute and a half. So really convenient and easy. Also grab the fire roasted bell peppers and onions. I love having this as well. This is great to just, you can make fajitas with this. You can toss them in an omelet or whatever you want. But honestly, it's great because you're just adding veggies to your meals. Now to one of my favorite veggie patties that Trader Joe's offers. This is the Thai sweet chili veggie burger. So delicious. I actually put these in my air fryer and then I'll just chop them up and dump them on top of a salad. I love the flavor of these. They have a delicious flavor and they pretty much go with anything that you want to add like a protein to. I really like it. So if you guys are looking to add something to make your salads a little better, or if you want to make a burger out of it, or you can even toss it on top of a bed of rice with some soy sauce, it's literally so versatile and so yummy. This is great. Moving on. So I got pretty much every mac and cheese that Trader Joe's offers because I wanted to show you guys what they have. So I'm going to start right here with a seasonal mac and cheese that's finally back in stock. This is the French onion macaroni and cheese. This came out for the first time last year. Brand new product. A lot of people loved it. It is massive. It is a huge meal. And it has a bunch of different cheeses. It has Swiss and cheddar, croutons and roasted onions. And then I just wanted to mention though, somebody was talking about this last night. So this is 960 calories per the entire serving. So you might want to share it. And the sodium content. Close your eyes because the entire thing has 1,240 milligrams. So if you're worried about sodium, this is definitely not for you. This is like a sweet, or not a sweet treat. It is a treat, but it is like
over the top decadent. So this is great if you're gonna just do like a little side and you wanna scoop a little bit out for everybody. Or if you just wanna go big, you can eat it for lunch. And then this one you guys have seen before. This is Benson's favorite, my son. He's 5, he loves the reduced guilt one more than he likes the regular one. It's just lighter, it's not as heavy, and it has a really good flavor. So love this one. This is the original mac and cheese, the one that pretty much everybody buys. I see coming through the lines. Classic, traditional, it even has like the shredded cheese on top so it melts when you heat it up in the microwave. But another great item if you just wanna take something to grab and go for lunch, or if you just wanna have things on hand in the freezer in case you, you know, have a brain fog in the moment of deciding what to eat, which I feel like is me every day. Also, we've got the Hatch Chili Mac and Cheese. This one is phenomenal. I love Hatch chilies, so if you like that flavor, it really is immersed into this mac and cheese, and it's amazing. And then the last one that I've never tried before because it has pepperoni in it, but it's a pepperoni pizza mac and cheese bowl. A lot of people love this one too. And then of course I forgot the gluten-free one. I didn't forget, we were sold out, so I didn't get the opportunity to get it, but there is a gluten-free one with spiral noodles. Absolutely delicious. I love that one too, and I was bummed that it was sold out, but hey, I guess a lot of people are buying the gluten-free mac this year. So there you go. Those are the options for frozen mac and cheese at Trader Joe's. Now to another one of my favorite frozen veggies is the organic rainbow cauliflower. I use this in everything, specifically actually the tikka masala I just made the other night. I dumped this entire bag into it, so I had to replenish and get a new one. But I love putting this in my ramen as well, or just as a side on top of rice. I literally can eat veggies on anything, with anything. I love vegetables, so this is another great one to have on hand at all times. Now let's go to two brand new frozen products. We've got the Kahlua pork spring rolls and the Okie Dokie ice cream. Let's start here with the Kahlua pork spring rolls. So these are brand new. These are found in the appetizer case, at least at my Trader Joe's, but they're next to all the other spring rolls that Trader Joe's has. But this is a Hawaiian-inspired spring roll with smoke-flavored pork and veggies. We're gonna take a look here at the heating instructions, and they sure enough have the air fryer instructions, which is amazing. It literally says to cook for 10 minutes, so that's super easy. And then here are the nutrition facts on the back. 2 pieces is the serving size. You can see as I go the calories and all that fun stuff. And then of course the ingredient list here at the bottom. So it does have milk, soy, wheat, and coconut in it. But Tim will be trying these in the taste test and letting you know his honest opinion, as he always does, and how he likes these. Now let's take a good look at this brand new vegan Okie Dokie oat non-dairy frozen dessert. So another vegan ice cream. This is from New Zealand, or it's a New Zealand inspired dessert with caramel swirl and sponge candy bits. And let's take a look at the back. So we've got 260 calories as a serving, and the entire container is 770. Here's the rest of the nutrition facts and the ingredient list as well, if you guys can see that. Now, I have heard so many mixed reviews. This product actually, I feel like, is pretty controversial going into 2022, because there's so many people that either loved it or did not like it at all. And the consensus is the reason that it is not liked is because it has somewhat of a synthetic aftertaste. So I'm not sure, I haven't tried it, but of course we're trying this in the taste test for tomorrow, and definitely let you know how I feel about it. And I try not to let anyone else's opinion sway mine. So if I love it, I'll let you guys know, but I'm letting you know what I've been hearing, so that way we have a full overview of what everyone thinks. But yeah, this is exciting. I'm so excited to try it and see how it goes. And then the last frozen product I grabbed was the organic jasmine rice. So this is something I haven't purchased in a while because I've been making a ton of homemade rice, but I just recently used up my last bag of rice. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna make it a little easy on myself. So I grabbed you know, the pre-made easy to microwave box of rice, but it definitely is way more expensive and not very economical if you're trying to budget. So it's a splurge for sure. I'm gonna go ahead and put all the frozen away, and I will be back to give you the rest of the haul. All right, we're chugging right along through the produce. So I grabbed some romaine salad, the organic one. The only reason I got this is because we didn't have organic romaine hearts at my work. We're not getting them in. So You know, you got to make do. And I know this time is so weird in the world where you go to get something and it's not there. And I've just learned that this is my year of learning patience and, you know, just realizing that not everything needs to be here for me at all times because it's not all about me. So I don't know if that's helpful to anyone, but for me, I just needed to like slow down and stop taking it personal because obviously there's things that are not in our control in this world right now. So I'm gonna take what I can get. So I got the pre-bagged, already washed for me, even more convenient, just a little more expensive, romaine salad for everything that I need, lettuce for. I also grabbed some organic celery. It had been coming in like not looking very good recently, but this batch actually looks fantastic. So I grabbed some of this. I've been chopping up carrots, celery. I have cucumbers at all times. And I've just been loving having this as a snack. I just keep it in some water in a Tupperware in my fridge. It's extra crispy if you keep this cut up in water and it lasts forever. I'm not even kidding, months it can last. So I've been loving having that as a snack. Instead of going for crunchy chips, I'm going for crunchy veggies. I also picked up a bag of organic broccoli florets. Again, not being the frozen broccoli florets, the organic ones have not been coming in either. So I am going to get the fresh ones for now, which is fine because I love fresh broccoli. So that's why I grabbed that. Then look at what came back in. These are the Korean pears. These are massive this year and they are supposed to be super, super juicy and sweet. I mean, they're kind of a crunchy pear, but I think we're gonna try this in the taste test because this just looks so good. And I'm not kidding, this year they're coming in huge. So if you have been looking forward to trying these, go now and get them. And then I got some Kumato tomatoes. These are the tomatoes I've been going for recently. I used to always get the organic on the vine. They really didn't ever taste like much. These actually taste like tomatoes, like grown from the ground. They're delicious. I love them. I wish they were organic, but you know what? It's fine. So I've been buying these all the time and just using them for everything. We've been making BLTs a lot for lunch, which has been really delicious. I obviously use not real bacon, but Tim does and he's been loving that. So these are my veggies that I got for the week. And then I got a ciabatta demi baguette. I just thought it'd be really nice to make maybe like a panini this weekend or something like that, or maybe even more BLTs on this bread because I was making them on the little rolls, the kind of like the Hawaiian rolls that Trader Joe's sells. So I ran out of those. So I got this one and I love this bread. It's so good. Moving on to some refrigerated items. We've got some new stuff up in here. So we've got the pizza bread cheese. If you remember, there was the garlic bread cheese last year. Now we've got the pizza bread cheese. This is a cow's milk cheese seasoned and baked golden brown. All you do is heat and eat. So you can microwave for 30 seconds or saute it and dip it in your favorite sauce. So this is a very like squeaky, chewy cheese and it doesn't really melt. So it's perfect for if you're gonna do like a cheese board or like an appetizer. This would be really nice, especially with the sauce. I think the sauce will make it because sometimes just having like a chunk of cheese is almost too much. But I like the idea of having like some marinara on the side that you can dip or even put them on like little toothpicks in like a little bath of sauce, like in a little cup. So I don't know, it's fun, it's interesting. We'll try this in the taste test as well. Then we've got this brand new sesame teriyaki beef skirt steak. We're not trying this in the taste test because Tim would have to fire up the grill and cook it all. And he usually likes to save cooking meat until he has like a friend over that he can share it with or family. So we'll just wait until he's ready to make this and maybe I'll get it on camera to show you if he likes it or not. But this is brand new. A lot of people are excited about it because it is that sesame teriyaki flavor. But yeah, brand new to Trader Joe's. Then we also got the Italian liguori. I love how they actually have the pronunciation here for me so I don't botch it. So liguori, semi-soft cheese. This is made in the mountains of Trentino region of Italy. And it looks amazing. I'm super excited to try this. I believe this is a spotlight cheese of the month. I could be wrong, but I think it is. And one thing that it does say on here is that it is a microbial enzyme. So yay, I can try it. And then the last cheese I wanted to show you is the unexpected cheddar. I've been getting a lot of messages about this cheese. Some people thought it was discontinued. It's not, it's still around. So all Trader Joe's did was This used to be a standard block of cheese, all the same price across the board. It literally just had a SKU on the back. Now they are cutting it into size, like by pound. So if you want a different size, you can get a bigger one, a smaller one. I got pretty much like the same as they sold them before. Same size block, I should say, but I think they just wanted it to be a little bit more convenient for people that are looking for a specific size or weight of cheese, so that's why they changed it up. But yeah, it's still around and it just looks a little different, and you have a little bit better selection now if you want to cater to your needs and how many people you're serving, so that's great. Got some more organic vegetable radiatori pasta. Got this rum. So this is called Rum of the Gods. This is a really popular seller at Trader Joe's. People buy this all the time because of the price point, and the quality is really good. So we actually got this one as a gift for someone in our family. It's their birthday and they love Mai Tais. So we thought this was a great addition to the gift we're getting them. And so that's why I grabbed it. Now I also grabbed some oven baked cheese bites. These are pretty much keto. So if you're keto and you're looking for a good snack, this one is perfect for you. But the reason I buy these is for Tim. So if you don't know, Trader Joe's discontinued the croutons that they had for years and they're gone now. So there's no croutons at Trader Joe's. So Tim has gotten creative and he's using these now as croutons. So basically they're just like little cheese bites. And that's what he uses for his salads now. So, you know, you gotta make it work. Now we are at a brand new instant oatmeal flavor. It's been a while since I've seen a new flavor of instant oatmeal at Trader Joe's, but this one is the cocoa and sea salt. That sounds amazing. I love sea salt in a lot of things, especially things with chocolate. So there are 10 oatmeal packets in here, and let's go ahead and look at the back, the nutrition facts. You can see the calories, you can see the ingredient list, all that fun stuff. And I believe it's fairly easy to make this. So yeah, you just use a microwave or just hot water. So I'll try this in the taste test. We'll all have a little sampler of this and see how it goes. I have high hopes though. This flavor is intriguing and it sounds better than like the majority of the flavors that instant oatmeal offers. So I'm excited to try it. It's unique, so that's why I like it. Unique and new, very fun. Moving on to the last few things that I grabbed. So got some pineapple juice in a can. I have showed this throughout my hauls in the years. This is great to have on hand, especially if you are someone that doesn't like have juice around readily. See, like us, we don't really have juice. We typically are water drinkers, sparkling water drinkers. And this is just nice to have if you just want some juice or if you want to make a mixed drink. These are great as well. I just got them to have on hand because I don't have any right now, so that's why I got them. And then down here, we got the strawberry smoothies, Benson's request. He used to drink one of these every single day. He stopped doing that, he got sick of them, but then randomly, a couple days ago, he's like, can you get me strawberry smoothies? So there you go. And we're still going strong on the grapefruit segment kick. Tim's been requesting these, he's been eating them like every day. And then this is a brand new product. This is the grain-free cheeseburger flavor dog treats. And you better believe that the dogs will be in the taste test this week. Look at how cute the actual treats look, like burgers. And I think, yeah, they're cheeseburger flavor. So I can't wait to see my dog's reaction and see if they like them or not. I think they will. So we'll show you guys in the taste test. And then the last thing I grabbed are the Madeline cookies. So during pumpkin season, I buy the pumpkin Madelines, my absolute favorite. I love those things. They're so good. These are the traditional ones that Trader Joe's has year round. I don't think I've ever had one, and that's crazy because I love the pumpkin Madeline so much. You would think I'd buy the traditional. So today's the day. We are trying these in the taste test. I'm gonna let you know my opinion, but I am so excited, and I think these would be great with like a little bit of ice cream or, for me, coffee. Coffee is always my pairing for anything sweet. So super excited to finally try these and let you know about an old product that's been around forever and one that I haven't tried yet. So this is the haul. I know it's a little small. All the frozen stuff's back in the freezer, but there you go. And I will hopefully see you guys in the taste test tomorrow so we can all figure out what is good and what we will pass on.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm so excited to do this taste test this week. I can't wait to bite into that pear. I've been staring at it. I bought it on Tuesday and it's been sitting and waiting for me to take a bite. So I can't wait to share with you guys how that is because I've heard rave reviews, but all said and done, I am so looking forward to this year and I can't wait to see what Trader Joe's is gonna surprise us with. Last year I felt like was very successful with new products and I feel like this year is gonna be even better, but we shall see. And of course, make sure you are subscribed, your notifications are turned on, and you give this video a thumbs up to continue all of our success into 2022. I love you all and thank you so much for tuning in and watching. I'll see you guys in the taste test tomorrow, and yeah, see you in my next video. Bye.